Let's say that you have a cherry pie store, and you've noticed that there is variability in the number of cherries on each pie that you sell. Some pies might have over 100 cherries, while other pies might have fewer than 50 cherries. So what you're curious about is, what is the distribution? How many of the different types of pies do you have? How many pies do you have that have a lot of cherries? How many pies do you have that have very few cherries? How many pies are in between? And so to do that, you set up a histogram. What you do is you take each pie in your store. Let's see if I can draw. You draw a pie of some kind. It's a cherry pie. I don't know if this is an adequate drawing of a pie. But you take each of the pies in your store, and you count the number of cherries on it. So this pie right over here is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Let's say you keep counting, and let's say it has 32 cherries. And you do that for every pie. And then you created buckets, because you don't want to create just a graph of how many have exactly 32. You just want to get a general sense of things. So you create buckets of 30. You say, how many pies have between 0 and 29 cherries? How many pies have between 30 and 59, including 30 and 59? How many pies have at least 60 and at most 89 cherries? How many pies have at least 90 and at most 119? And then how many pies have at least 120 and at most 149? And you know that you don't have any pies that have more than 149 cherries, so this should account for everything. And then you count them. So for example, you say, okay, 5 pies have 30 to 59 cherries. And so we create a histogram, or you create a histogram, and you make this magenta bar go up to 5. So that's how you would construct this histogram. That's what this pies at different cherry levels histogram is telling us. So now that we know how to construct it, let's see if we can interpret it based on the information given in the histogram. So the first question is, based on just this information, can you figure out the total number of pies in your store, assuming that they're all accounted for by this histogram? And I encourage you to pause the video and try to figure it out on your own. Well, what's the total number of pies? Well, let's see. There's five pies have at least 30 cherries, but no more than 59. You have 8 pies in this blue bucket. You have 4 pies in this green bucket. And then you have, what is this? This is 3 pies that have at least 120, but no more than 149 cherries. And this accounts for all of the pies. So the total number of pies you have at this store are 5 plus 8 plus 4 plus 3, which is what? 5 plus 8 is 13. Plus 4 is 17, plus 3 is 20. So there are 20 pies in this store. But then you can ask a more nuanced question. What if you wanted to know the number of pies with more than 60 cherries? The number of pies with more than 60. So number of pies with, let's say 60 or more. 60 or more cherries. So let's think about it. Well, this magenta bar doesn't apply because these all have less than 60. But all of these other bars are counting pies that have 60 or more cherries. This is 60 to 89. This is 90 to 119. This is 120 to 149. So it's going to be these eight pies that are in this bucket, plus these 4 pies, plus these 3 pies. So it is going to be essentially everything but this first bucket. Everything but all the pies except for these 5 pies have 60 or more cherries. So it should be 5 less than 20. And so let's see, 8 plus 4 is 12, plus 3 is 15, which is 5 less than 20. So using this histogram, we can answer a really interesting question. We can say, well, wait, how many more pies do we have that have 60 to 89 cherries than 120 to 149 cherries? Well, we say, well, we have 8 pies that have 60 to 89 cherries, 3 that have 120 to 149. So we have 5 more pies in the 60 to 89 category than we do in the 120 to 149 category. So a lot of questions that we can start to answer. And hopefully this gives you a sense of how you can interpret histograms.